Now a turnover on downs. Their own 34. Across the middle, Terrence Dixon. Wide open. And Dixon towards the pylon for another touchdown. There is a penalty marker down near the 7. For the moment, it's a 34-yard score.
I think we might get some type of illegal crackback block on Georgia State.
But Jamari Trash, I think, Hudson, involved in that sequence working against Brett Anderson. Well, big call in this one, as Anderson appears to be okay.
Personal foul with targeting. Number 2, offense. 15-yard penalty for the spot of the foul. The previous play is under review.
You can see here, I mean, he hits Anderson straight on, but he hits him head-to-head. It's helmet-to-helmet. So I think that's the correct call, the targeting call, and I think that's probably going to stand. Jamari Thrash going in there on Anderson. You can see the helmet-to-helmet contact.
Well, you're looking for the launch. You're looking for the contact in the head or neck area. Forcible contact. I believe that checks all the boxes. Of course, replay will try to confirm.
After further review, there is no targeting on the play. However, the 15-yard penalty for the personal foul blindside block is enforced from the spot of the foul.
Wow.
15 yards from 10-yard line. The ball is still beyond the line to gain. First down. Georgia State.
Well, I think that they've done a great job to try to take the subjective nature out of the call, but a lot happening here.
See, I thought that this would have been a targeting call, not a blindside. I mean, it's pretty straightforward. I mean, blindside block is when the guy is running, you know, down the field and kind of somebody comes and attacks him and hits him from the side. The blindside. I'm a bit confused. I thought that was more so about targeting, more so than blindside.